Our next guest is a Marine. He's come face to face with terror on more than one occasion, touring in both Iraq and Afghanistan, lost both his legs disarming bombs. Marine bomb technician Staff Sergeant Joey Jones is with us. Sergeant, welcome to the program. It's good to have you with us.
Thank you. Good morning.
First of all, before we discuss your injury and how it happened and how you recovered, these IEDs, some of them were discovered in this house in California. How easy are they to make?
Well, the information's out there, that's for sure. Timothy McVeigh, Eric Rudolph, all the way back to the IRA in the 70s have shown you can make a homemade bomb pretty easily and employ it if you have the will. You know, here in this country, we've done a great job with intelligence. We've done a great job at talking about defeating terrorism, domestic terrorism. But at the end of the day, these things are easily made, and the precursors or the materials are pretty easy to get a hold of.
Now, you were injured by an IED, is that correct?
Yes, sir. In Afghanistan back in 2010.
You lost both your legs?
I did. I lost both my legs, but I had a second chance at life, so no complaints here.
Now, how did it happen? Were you trying to dismantle an IED and it went off, or exactly what happened?
Well, one thing that a lot of people don't understand is that Iraq and Afghanistan were two vastly different wars. A lot of people look at my job, the bomb tech field, and they think Hurt Locker with robots and trucks and bomb suits. In Afghanistan, especially after 2009, that simply wasn't the case. The terrain didn't allow for us to use the gear that we've created to defeat these things, so it was mostly hands-on procedures, sitting over top of it, taking it apart. So my field, which is a relatively small field, took a large number of casualties and a large number of injuries. I personally was on my 79th IED when I stepped on one beside it I just didn't know was there.
Oh, that's how it happened. It wasn't the one you were trying to take to pieces. It was the one that you didn't see and you stepped on it. Good heavens. Now, tell us about the second lease on life. Is that the prosthetic legs that you have there?
No, I had a second chance at life because the IED that took my legs could have taken my life, and it did take the life of a Marine standing next to me. And, you know, that's the irony of war. I stepped on it. He unfortunately lost his life, so I live this life, and I live it to the fullest in his memory and in his honor, and especially those men and women serving today.
I guess what we're all facing is those IEDs coming to America. I mean, if they're relatively simple to put together and you can build 12 of them in somebody's garage in San Bernardino, that's what we're facing, really, isn't it?
Absolutely. It is a very, very important threat that we need to recognize. I understand the conversation of gun control. I understand the conversation of immigration. But at the end of the day, we have what are called lone wolf terrorists, sympathizers, people that are reached through social media. If we're not going to stop that, then we have to look at the precursors, the products used, fertilizer, diesel fuel, the purchase habits of people who may be on a watch list, and understand what it is they're trying to do. And with these IEDs, one thing that is incredibly interesting is that we could defeat them in Afghanistan or Iraq with jamming devices and other type of sophisticated gear. We can't use that here.
Right.
Our lifestyle in this country allows for us to use cell phones and garage door openers.
That's a very good point. Sergeant Joey Jones, thank you very much for joining us, sir, and thank you for your service.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.